this, over 2,000 years ago, that a very special child is born. But there's more to the story than anyone really knows.
Oh, yes. It's the greatest story never told. And tonight we'll hear it from those who were there. Oh, the night when Christ was born.
Where the blessed child first showed his face to the light. What's happening there tonight?
Who lives there now that the child's gone? Why, the ones that went there on that night, filled with love, a donkey.
Feliz Navidad. A sheep.
Feliz Navidad.
And the donkey.
What do you think?
Try a little to the left. No, not you, the barcode.
Closer.
A little higher. A little higher. A little higher. I liked it when you first had it.
Oh. How's that?
It should be a star on top, not an angel.
Oh! How's that?
I like the angel better.
Are you crazy? The star is perfect.
Absolutely not. No. Young man, there's nothing I know
how to do. Because Christmas trees have stars.
Or an angel.
Oh, a star, definitely.
Epic fail.
But angels appeared in the sky the night the child was born. You saw them.
Wait a minute. You saw angels appear in the sky?
Sure. There was one right above us. I remember because I said, hey, look, there's an angel right above us.
Hold on. You mean you were there?
Not there, kid. Here. This is where it happened.
It happened in this barn?
Yep, right over there.
Wow! I can't believe the child was born in this manger!
That's right, and if it weren't for me, it never would have happened.
What are you prattling on about?
People don't realize it, but it's because of me, the donkey. That the child was born in a manger.
No, it's because of you that people think donkeys are liars! How do you figure that?
Simple. There were two people traveling on the road to Bethlehem that night. Their wagon broke down and they were stuck in the middle of nowhere. Things couldn't have been worse. Ha!
Oh yeah, they could have listened to this story.
Quiet! The sun had gone down, and it was starting to get cold. Mary was about to have a baby. Joseph was worried the child wouldn't survive the cold night air. But I thought, hey, look on the bright side. At least it isn't snowing. The only thing that could save them now was a miracle. But where does one find a miracle? On a deserted country road to Bethlehem. Yeah, baby! And that's when I came to the rescue. Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by.
Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light.
The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight.
The donkey gave him a lift and a gift. He lent a helping hand to people in need. And it's that spirit of giving that is at the heart of our Christmas story. And it starts softly, quietly.
Joy, 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 joy to the world.
How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of.
Cause the child to be born here?
Oh, yeah. If you
you recall, there was only one inn open in Bethlehem that night, and they had no rooms left.
Away in a manger, one baby. Away in a manger, no rooms at the inn. A child is waiting for life to begin.
Honey, I finished feeding the animals.
Did you lock up?
I'm hanging up the key to the barn right now.
Well, turn down the lamp before you come to bed. Our oil bills are going through the roof.
I was trying to build my nest that night, and I was looking for things to build it with, when something shiny caught my eye. Ooh.
Excuse me.
Oh, hello! Reservations? Vacation club?
No, but we'd like a room for the night.
Sorry, we're all booked.
Well, is there another inn nearby?
Let's see. There's the Holy Day Inn, and the Best Middle Eastern, but they're all full up tonight.
Where are we going to stay?
Let's see. The attic's full of boxes. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait a minute! We've got a barn out back! You're welcome to sleep there. At least you'll be out of the snow.
Well,
have a little faith.
All right.
Great! Well, follow me.
Don't worry. We'll leave a light on for you.
Away in a manger, no crib for his bed. The little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay. Close by me forever, and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care. And take us to heaven to live with thee there.
So the dove got a place for the night. So did Mary and Joseph. By taking that route, they showed us how having a little faith in the unexpected can lead to unexpected blessings. Ones that even a mother couldn't have predicted.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby Dumb.
if it weren't for me, Mary and Joseph would never have come into this barn, and the child wouldn't have been born in that manger.
Wow! That's amazing!
Yes! Amazing that anyone would actually believe such nonsense.
What are you talking about?
No, what are you talking about? Imagine a donkey and a dove trying to take credit for the birth of the child. Everyone knows it was the sheep who was responsible.
Now, listen here, you Q-tip.
Well, you may have brought Mary and Joseph to the inn, and by offering that key, you may have put them in the barn. But I'm the reason why that child was born inside that manger.
You are?
Absolutely. You see, it was freezing when Mary and Joseph arrived. There wasn't even a small fire to keep them warm.
What child is this? What child is this?
Now, there's nothing easy about having a baby in a barn. For one thing, when your child grows up and leaves the door open, you can't say, "Excuse me, were you born in a barn?" And that night, the wind was howling. The air was bitterly cold. But Joseph tried to help.
Here, put this around you.
It's too cold. This blanket won't keep the baby warm enough. The child will be here soon, Joseph. What are we going to do?
You heard the innkeeper. There's no other place for us to go.
But how can we possibly stay here?
Had they gone back out into the snow, they would have surely perished. That's why I, the sheep, came over and saved Mary and the baby.
This wool, it's so soft and warm.
Oh, when to Bethlehem they came and knew not where to stay, they felt the warmth and kindness of sheep that feed on hay.
His mother Mary gently unto the Lord did pray, all tidings of comfort and joy.
Stranger?
So, you want to know who to thank for it happening here? That's right, me! Think about that the next time you're ordering lamb chops.
Wow, I can't believe it! You're the reason the child was born in this manger!
Oh, please! Mary and Joseph wouldn't have even come into the barn if it wasn't for me!
So, they wouldn't have made it to Bethlehem if it weren't for me! You all just want to talk about it!
Silence! Shame on you! All fighting to take credit!
Oh, great! Now we're gonna find out it was a camel who saved the child!
Quiet! None of you did anything by yourselves. You all three helped. And that is why you are all three important.
He's right. We shouldn't be trying to take credit like this. After all, you're important, and you're important. And me, I'm the most important because I brought Mary and Joseph to Bethlehem.
In case you didn't notice, there were others here that night who also welcomed the child.
Oh, that's right! There were angels, remember?
I'm the one who spotted them.
I said, hey, look, there's angels right above us!
I'm not talking about angels.
Wait a minute. Are you saying that you were here too?
My two brothers and I brought wise men from afar, bearing gifts.
Everyone was here except me! I sure wish I could have seen it!
It's not so hard to see it. Just open your heart. Because every time you help someone in need, or have faith in the unexpected, or give comfort to a stranger, you are sharing the spirit of Christmas! And you'll see it right away. A sight so astonishing you'll never forget! Can you do that?
What child?